Good morning, fans of PrivateerFX. Monday, August 6th. Not much going on today, data-wise. Germany, factory orders out of Germany in about an hour and 15 minutes. We do have the RBA board meeting, which will be tomorrow morning, sort of 6:30 Swiss time. So that might be interesting. You might see some different commentary from the RBA based on the escalation of the China-US battle, trade battle, whatever that is. Let's look at the charts real quick. The front page of the Wall Street this morning is robust earnings from stocks. Strong earnings so far. Equities, mid-range here. We got to keep an eye on this. This is a tug of war between overall valuation, which is quite high, geopolitical, which is negative, earnings, which is positive. The main high here in the NASDAQ. This high is incredibly important. It's now 100 points away, 120 points away, 75.33. Kind of looking for bearish engulfing today. I don't know why. I just have a sort of intuitive feeling on this. So 73.62. What was yesterday? The last week, yeah. 73.62 is last week's low. We're not selling high ones here. But we're just having a peek at this. Somehow this doesn't feel super right. But we'll see. Back to currencies, more of our stronger suit. Euro looks like 115 is in play this week. Very, very quiet. We've had, we also have some holiday time today. Australia was out. Canada is also out today, so liquidity will be a little bit less in the commodity currencies. We're through 60, which was Friday's low. Now we're basically 50 points away from one of the most looked at levels in a long time, 115.08. This feels like it has to trade sometime in the next sort of 3 days. So core shorts is the way, euro dollar. Cable, Liam Fox, not really helping Cable with some negative chatter about hard Brexit and all sorts of silly stuff. This does look like it's going to test this 129.60 low for the year. So it's important just mainly because it's pretty darn low, but also it's the low for the year, so this looks like it's going to get tested next couple days as well. Dollar yen not doing much. Had a bearish engulfing on Friday on that non-farm number, which was, I would say, inadequate for dollar yen, plus dollar lower on geopolitical stuff. This has a lot more to do with euro-yen than the U.S. geopolitical situation. People are starting to worry about Italy again, so euro-yen got slapped, as you can see. New lows, so we're in this downtrend, boom, squeeze up to 131, now we've made new lows. This looks like it's going to continue lower as well. The next big level here is 128.47. Ideally, we get a touch and a bounce here. And perhaps we can smack the pony through that level. Aussie yen, not doing much. The macro play here is short. We got RBA tomorrow, so careful with Aussie positions. Speaking of the devil, we almost bullish engulfed here, which would have been very important because the market is short Aussie. I think what you could probably look to see here is a little bit of short covering into the RBA. You may make some highs up here, but the selling forces seem very strong in Aussie. So selling high ones is probably a good idea. I don't think this is going to pop out and rip massively to the top side, but I do think we're going to clear 74.11, maybe trade up to 25 or 45, maybe even nip through 63 on a really extreme short squeeze. But selling high ones in Aussie seems to make sense to me. We're going to have a more specific strategy as we get closer to RBA. Dollar CAD not doing much. Dollar ZAR not doing much, although it looks like it's kind of turned here. We've had a series of higher lows, higher highs. Kind of ran out of steam up there at 50, but with Euro dollar heading towards 115 and perhaps some risk off coming, I don't know, this could be a clever way to trade risk off, buy some dollars ZAR. Not to mention the land appropriation bullshit that went around last week. That can never be good for that country. Here we are, dollar max. Not really sure what to do with this now. I thought this was the turn here. I'll move back up to 1910. But now it's just sitting here, doing a sideways dance. It kind of looks like it wants to head lower. No playing dollar max for now. Dollar turkey, we no dog in this fight. We're just kind of laughing at this poor country and the people who live there. Purchasing power just getting destroyed. Probably not a bad time to buy a coastal property in Turkey. But certainly Privateer's not looking, so good luck with that. Anyway, sum things up. Quiet day ahead on the financial side, but Euro dollar now 50 points away from bingo. 115.08. Looks like it's going to have to attract. Of course, short Euro, and then we're watching this Euro yen at 50. For perhaps a break trading through there. All right, keep an eye on the Italian headlines and start preparing for the RBA, which is 24 hours away, but preparation is the mother of success. Good luck, people. Talk to you soon. Ciao.